What's up? What's up with it? Brandon Scoopy Robinson. You know what it is. Scoopy Unfiltered through the Basketball Society Network. And last week, I was really pleased with the conversation I had with you guys about the Golden State Warriors, Steph Curry, and D'Angelo Russell, and some of those other things to continue with the Western Conference talk. I'm not ready to crown them an NBA playoff appearance-ready team yet. But a team that I'm interested in is the Oklahoma City Thunder, obviously with Paul George headed over to the Los Angeles Clippers and Russell Westbrook over now with the Houston Rockets. The perception of that team has changed, but I like the young youth movement with the Oklahoma City Thunder, primarily with Shai Gilgeous-Alexander. He had a lot of experience this past season on the roster of the LA Clippers, who, you know, did go toe-to-toe with the Golden State Warriors in the playoffs this past year. A Golden State Warriors team that did make it to the NBA Finals with Kevin Durant and, you know, Steph Curry and those guys. But, you know, the Clippers didn't win, but I definitely think there was a confidence booster there. And so for Shai Gilgeous-Alexander to kind of come in and with the Oklahoma City Thunder and kind of guide that team, I'm excited for that. It's perceived that Chris Paul at some point will be traded. From everything that I've heard back in July during my trip to Oklahoma, the Miami Heat are the team of interest of Chris Paul, but there are some factors that, you know, go into whether or not he'll go. So he is on that team for now. But when you look at the Oklahoma City Thunder, there are literally six players on that team that are listed at guard. Easily comes to mind is Alex Gilgeous-Alexander, like I said, as well as Terrence Ferguson and what have you. And so when you look at that team, there is a logjam at guard. The benefit that the Oklahoma City Thunder do have is the gluttonous amount of draft picks that they'll receive moving forward. And it is a movement that is being, you know, looked at. I mean, you still have Steven Adams on that team, Andre Roberson, and more. But I'm excited to see what will become of the Thunder, primarily because if you look at the Thunder's history, they were a team that was built through draft picks. You look at Russell Westbrook, who started out in Seattle, and they ended up moving to Oklahoma. Then you look at Kevin Durant, who came along with him. But then they drafted a guy named James Harden. I think you've heard of him. And that was a team that visited the NBA Finals in 2012, did lose to the Miami Heat. But one thing I can say, if the Thunder created anything, they made a believer out of people by creating a culture in Oklahoma. And I think if anything is possible, Presti and those within an organization could potentially do it again and replicate that. And I think Shai Gilgeous-Alexander is a guy with the playoff experience that he had as just a rookie, playing with guys like Patrick Beverley, playing with guys like Lou Williams, a six-man of the year threat every year. I think taking that mindset and taking that experience, I mean, he wasn't a chump coming out of college, taking that experience and becoming the face of that team is really not that hard. And so those are my thoughts on this week's episode of Scoop Be Unfiltered. Not saying that the Thunder will be a playoff team this year. The Western Conference is very, very, very competitive, anywhere from the Clippers to the Lakers to the Houston Rockets, and as well as the Portland Trail Blazers and the Utah Jazz. But what I am saying is they'll be an interesting and entertaining team to watch grow in the foreseeable future. The Thunder really and truly are a team that you should be paying attention to for the next few years, with the amount of draft picks, with the young talent they have, and with Shai Gilgeous-Alexander as potentially the face of that organization. That's all I have for now. Make sure you continue to subscribe to the Scoop Be Unfiltered segment every week, which is available on Basketball Society's YouTube channel. And that's all I got. Enjoy your week, y'all. Talk to you soon.